Hello students, how are you all? Welcome to online classes. In the last session we have started electrode potentials, standard electrode potentials, standard oxidation potentials, standard reduction potentials, and as per IUPAC convention, all potentials considered as SRP, standard reduction potentials. Afterwards, E cell, EMF of the cell. Next, cell representation, how to represent a cell. So these are the topics we have completed in the last session. So in this session I am going to discuss a new topic, that is single electrode potentials. So after that we will discuss electrochemical series. Now single electrode potential, for example, if you take galvanic cell, it is a galvanic cell which contains two half parts, okay. So two electrodes are connected by wire, next, and two half cells are connected by salt bridge, and this is zinc sulfate, it is copper sulfate, right students? This is a simple setup for which one, a galvanic cell. So if I took only one electrode, if I didn't take this, just imagine only one electrode I took, I didn't take the second one. One electrode means a single electrode. The single electrode potential is very difficult to measure because the circuit is incomplete. It means if second one is there, circuit is complete. Second one is not there, circuit is incomplete. That's why it's very difficult to measure the single electrode potentials, because the circuit is incomplete. To measure single electrode potentials, it should be coupled with another half cell, that should be as a reference one, that should be a comfortable one to measure all types of single electrodes. So this is called a reference electrode. Reference electrode means to measure a single electrode potential, another one is required to complete the circuit. The required one is called a reference electrode. So in our syllabus, the reference electrode given is hydrogen electrode, standard hydrogen electrode, also called normal hydrogen electrode. We'll discuss now. It is a very difficult to measure single electrode potentials, okay, because the circuit is incomplete. The circuit is incomplete. To measure single electrode potential, it should be coupled with another half cell called reference electrode. It should be coupled, then the circuit will be completed. Then easily measures, okay. This is a reference cell given in our syllabus is standard hydrogen electrode. It is, so example for reference cell is standard hydrogen electrode, also called normal hydrogen electrode, also called normal hydrogen electrodes. So both names are correct. So this will be taken as a reference one to measure the single electrode potential, which is unknown, right? Now a vessel is taken, in that a platinum wire is taken which is coated with a platinum black. Platinum wire is taken coated with a platinum black. So it is taken in a glass vessel. It is a glass vessel, students, right? And to this bottom there is a platinum strip. It is platinum strip which is coated with a platinum black. Platinum strip, this whole arrangement is taken in another vessel. This is another vessel, students. Here there is a outlet. Through this I can pass hydrogen gas. Pressure is 1 bar pressure. Temperature is 25 degrees Celsius, right? Then a part of this hydrogen gas is bubbled out. It means the gas will be removed from the liquid by bubbles especially. So this rod is taken in acidic solution, nothing but HCl or H2SO4, whatever it is. In this, the taken one is acidic solution. It is concentrated HCl. Its molarity is 1 molar, unity, molarity is unity. Getting all of you? This is the normal hydrogen electrode. Simply, it is 3 marks question, students, very, very important. Number of times asked question it is. They asked number of times, 3 marks question. You can explain this in a clear manner, that is. So it has a platinum wire coated with a platinum black which is dipped in a concentrated HCl solution or acidic solution. So at the bottom a platinum strip is taken with a platinum coated, platinum black coated. So through this hydrogen gas is passed. A part of hydrogen gas is bubbled out. And the rest of the hydrogen gas will be adsorbed on the platinum strip. So there is an equilibrium established between the H2 gas adsorbed and H plus ions in the acidic solution. So H plus ions are released from HCl solution. So number of H plus ions is equal to number of H2 gas molecules adsorbed on a platinum strip. Equilibrium is established. The electrode potential they measured experimentally for this hydrogen electrode, that is assumed to be 0.000 volts. That's why it is considered as a reference electrode. If I coupled with any single electrode, then obviously I will get a complete galvanic cell. Then I can measure the single electrode potential. Shall we write the description, students? So I will write the description, whatever I told. Okay, so whatever I discussed, I wrote on the board, right? So it consists of a platinum wire coated with a platinum black, which is dipped in a acidic solution. Hydrogen gas is bubbled through it. A part of hydrogen gas is adsorbed on the platinum strip and rest of the hydrogen gas will be escaped as a bubbles from the HCl solution. So there is an equilibrium established between the hydrogen gas adsorbed on the platinum strip and H plus ions in the acidic solution. So H2 gas and H plus ions. So hydrogen gas adsorbed on platinum strip is equilibrium with the hydrogen ions in the solution. Now the temperature must be maintained is 25 degrees Celsius. It means standard conditions, and the concentration is 1 molar, pressure is 1 bar. These three conditions are very, very important. Don't forget that, students. So the standard hydrogen electrode potential will be arbitrarily assumed as zero. Actually, some value is there, 0.00 something. So that is rounded to zero, students. So that's why it is considered as a reference cell. It means helping one, right? This will not affect the other electrode potential, right? When this half cell is connected to any other single or half cell, then we will get a complete galvanic cell. For example, if the zinc is not there, only copper electrode is there. In place of zinc, I can connect this one. I will get a copper electrode potential. If copper electrode is not there in galvanic cell, in place of copper electrode, I will connect the standard hydrogen electrode with zinc. Then we will get a galvanic cell. I can measure a zinc electrode potential. It means single electrode potential. So if it is act as anode, oxidation takes place, hydrogen lost electrons. If it is act as a cathode, hydrogen ions gain electrons, reduction takes place. It means it can act as anode, otherwise cathode, based on the absence one in the galvanic cell. So how to represent platinum solid, platinum inert electrode, and hydrogen gas I am passing. It is a gas and 1 bar pressure, and H plus ions are there. That's why it is aqueous solution, aqueous HCl nothing but, and 1 molar concentration. Like that we need to represent. Getting, students? Right. It is standard hydrogen electrode. 3 marks question, diagram 1 mark, description 2 marks. Very, very, very important. Just follow this. Okay. Next. How to calculate single electrode potential with the help of hydrogen electrode? We will discuss now. Yes. Students, actually galvanic cell contains 2 half parts. One is a zinc electrode, another one is a copper electrode. I removed zinc electrode, only copper electrode available. This is copper electrode. It is copper electrode, copper sulfate solution. It is copper sulfate, copper rod. This will be connected to this. Both are okay. So already these parts given to you, no need to write. You too also no need to write, just to understand I am drawing the diagram, students. It is a salt bridge. Okay, na? Actually I would like to measure the single electrode potential of a copper. I don't have zinc. If it is only available, it is a single electrode, very difficult because the circuit is incomplete. That's why to this normal hydrogen electrode is coupled. The normal hydrogen electrode is coupled with the single copper electrode. Then the circuit is completed. Then the circuit is completed. Getting, students? Then the circuit is completed. Then I can measure, right? So now how do measure, students? So this is single electrode potential. E cell is equal to, what is that, E naught cell, otherwise standard cell potential. Cell potential means both halves. E naught right side minus E naught left side. Yesterday, last class formula given. Cathode minus anode, right side minus left side. Then E naught cell is equal to, so E right side, E naught right side minus E naught left side will be zero. E naught left side will be 0 volts. Okay, it means E left is nothing but standard hydrogen electrode. For this value will be 0.0 volts. That's why left side, right minus left, right minus left. Right one don't know, then left one. Then E naught cell is equal to E naught right side. It means this is measured experimentally, then they got the value that is plus 0.34 volts E naught R. E naught R means, right side means E naught Cu plus 22 Cu. It is right side always reduction RR, right side reduction cathode, next one is positive, already given, right side reduction. Right students, like this they measured by coupling with hydrogen electrode. Then copper single electrode is measured as which one? 0.34 volts experimentally. Similarly, in galvanic cell, zinc electrode and copper electrode, both are there. If I remove copper electrode, in place of copper electrode, I can keep this, right? Yes, it is zinc electrode in galvanic cell. Actually here, which one must be there? Copper electrode. Instead of copper electrode, I am taking a reference cell. Only zinc electrode available for us, zinc rod. It is zinc sulfate solution. It is very difficult to measure the single electrode potential because the circuit is incomplete. That's why to this normal hydrogen electrode is coupled. I would like to take a normal hydrogen electrode. It is platinum wire coated with a platinum black, platinum strip, and this will be connected to this with a galvanometer, and it is a salt bridge. Okay students, they didn't give diagrams in the textbook. I'm showing with the diagrams. They gave only directly. Now, so this is HCl, concentrated HCl. Parts already we know already. It is left side LOAN, lone, we know already. Left side oxidation anode, right side reduction, next one cathode, positive charge, red cat already given. So it should undergoes oxidation actually. Right students, so they calculated, they started to calculate. So that is E cell is equal to, what is that? E cell, E naught cell, for example, E right side minus E left side. Standard reduction, potential of right side cathode minus left side anode. Then E naught cell is equal to E naught right side. Right side is, it is a standard hydrogen electrode, for this potential equal to zero. That's why right side will be zero minus. Next, this will be left side, E naught cell left side. Okay, like that they calculated. So if they calculated, the value got is minus, so that is 0.76. it is equal to plus, it is minus E naught left side. It is left side means this one. Then if it is they got a minus value, actually minus value this is. Then E left, it is okay here. Okay students, you just observe, left side I took a reduction, standard hydrogen electrode, right side is a zinc electrode. To calculate the zinc electrode single electrode potential, I should couple with which one? That is standard hydrogen electrode. It is standard hydrogen electrode. Left side lone actually, right side red cat. Okay, now so E naught cell, standard cell potential equal to E naught right side minus E naught left side. So E naught cell is equal to E naught right side, we don't know right side students, left side will be zero because left side standard hydrogen electrode. Then E naught right side zero, no? Okay, left side zero, right. E naught cell is equal to E naught right side. Right side means that is E naught Zn plus 2 to Zn. right side means generally reduction takes place, right side reduction takes place, that's why Zn plus 2 to Zn I have written, plus 2 gains 2 electron becomes Zn, that's okay. Now they measured this value, that is minus 0.76 volts. Students, you just observe carefully. This value and this value. This value is higher, this value is lower. Lower value indicates oxidation. Higher value indicates reduction. Remember, very, very important. So it is a, this means standard reduction potential of a zinc. Understood? As per IUPAC, oxidation also considered as a reduction. But based on the value, based on SRP value, if SRP value is low, oxidation. SRP value is high, reduction. Oxidation and reduction both considered as a reduction potentials only. But SRP value lower, that is oxidation. SRP value higher, reduction. Now, so the SRP of zinc is very low, very low. It indicates zinc undergoes oxidation gives Zn plus 2. Zinc undergoes oxidation then gives Zn plus 2. SRP value lower, that indicates oxidation. Practically zinc involved in oxidation. I have written right side, but practically zinc involved in oxidation because of SRP value, standard reduction potential value. So zinc is oxidized by which one? HCl. We can write here, students. Zinc oxidized to Zn plus 2 by H plus ions in standard hydrogen electrode. Okay? It means zinc oxidized to Zn plus 2 by which one? H plus ions. Very, very important. So it means zinc is oxidized. Oxidized means dissolved. Very, very important. Dissolved. Reduced means deposited. Dissolved means size decreased. Deposited means size increased. You have to remember, right? Zinc dissolved or oxidized by H plus ions. It means HCl. Very, very important. Now, zinc dissolved in HCl solution. Right. Condition is zinc dissolved. Same thing we have written. No? Zinc dissolved by HCl solution. No need to write once again, students. Very, very important it is. Now, next one. In this case, the standard reduction, it is also SRP value, no? It is also SR. Standard reduction potential of copper is plus 0.34. When compared with the minus, this is very high. That's why high means reduction, copper undergoes reduction. Yes. The SRP value of copper is high. It indicates Cu plus 2 reduced to Cu by hydrogen gas in which one? Standard hydrogen electrode. Getting, students? Cu plus 2 reduced like this. Cu plus 2 gains 2 electrons and Cu. This reaction will be happened with the help of hydrogen gas in the normal hydrogen electrode, which is coupled with a single copper electrode. Getting all of you? Yes. It means Cu plus 2 reduced to copper by hydrogen gas. Copper by hydrogen gas. Very very important. Reverse one also you can write. H plus ions cannot oxidize copper, or H plus ions cannot oxidize. Oxidize means dissolving. Cannot dissolve copper. Cannot dissolve copper. Cannot dissolve or nothing but oxidize copper. It's very very important. It means copper does not dissolve in HCl solution. It is also considered as copper does not dissolve in HCl solution. Very very important conditions. One statement you remember. Copper is reduced to, the SRP value of copper is very high, positive value, getting positive high SRP value indicates reduction. That's why Cu plus 2 ions reduced to Cu by hydrogen gas in the standard hydrogen electrode. That's what you remember. Getting all of you? Yes, it is standard hydrogen electrode. Next point, students, that is, this is a single electrode potential of which one? Copper. Single electrode potential of a zinc. Single electrode potential of a copper is 0.34. Single electrode potential of zinc is -0.76. Both are SRP values only, remember. So for example, if you take this is copper, students, already written clearly. If you take the yes, galvanic cell, it is galvanic cell which contains two half cells connected by a inverted U-shaped salt bridge. First half cell contains zinc sulfate and zinc rod dipped in this zinc rod. Second half cell contains copper rod and the solution taken is copper sulfate. And both are connected by wire. It is, yes, it is a galvanic cell. Left side it is lone, L-O-A-N. Right side red cat. It means reduction cathode positive charge right side. Already taken. Now you just observe clearly. How to measure E-cell or standard cell potential of a galvanic cell, right? So E naught cell of galvanic cell. So galvanic cell, best example is Daniell cell. The above cell is a Daniell cell. Okay. You know already E naught cell or EMF, whatever it is. E naught cell or EMF, both are same. E naught cell means measured under working. You know EMF means cell not under working. That is. That is E naught right side minus E naught left side. Right side means cathode, it is given clearly. E naught cathode minus E naught anode, it is. That is E naught cell of a Daniell cell. Cathode means E naught copper electrode, it is copper electrode. Copper single electrode is plus 0.34, already measured, students, copper single electrode potential, that is plus 0.34 volts minus next. So zinc single electrode potential is minus 0.76 volts. Then we will get plus 0.76. 1.10 volts. It means the potential difference between the zinc electrode and copper electrode measured by the single electrode potentials of copper electrode and zinc electrode. The single copper electrode potential is plus 0.34, that is on right side in the galvanic cell. And the single zinc electrode potential is minus 0.76, that should be placed on left side in the galvanic cell. If I calculated by a formula, E naught cell equal to E right minus E left plus 0.34 minus minus 0.76. Finally, you will get 1.10 volts. Very, very important. Okay. Next. After that, electrochemical series. Very, very important. Electrochemical series. Okay. Now the important 2 marks question is electrochemical series. A list of large number of electrodes like copper electrode, zinc electrode, sodium, whatever the electrode that is. So those will be arranged in increasing or decreasing order of their standard reduction potential values. The series named as electrochemical series. So top high value, bottom low value. So low to high I arranged, otherwise high to low I arranged here. It means a list of large number of electrodes arranged in decreasing or increasing order of their standard reduction potential values called electrochemical series, right? A list of large number of electrodes, nothing but elements, these are elements arranged in their arranged in decreasing or increasing order of their decreasing or increasing order of their standard reduction potential values called electrochemical series also called activity series, also called electromotive series, another names these are. Okay, so students, I arranged lithium at the bottom, lowest value. So F2 at the top, highest value. You need to write a few points here, students. Very, very important applications, observe clearly. So lowest SRP value indicates oxidation taking place at anode. Lithium always undergoes oxidation taking place at anode. Understood, all of you? Highest to SRP value indicates reduction, very, very important, taking place at cathode. We will discuss few points, right? So this value is, lithium has lowest SRP value, hence lithium always involved in oxidation at anode. It is oxidation taking place at anode. The species which is involved in oxidation is called a reducing agent. Hence, lithium is strong reducing agent. Strong reducing agent. So you remember reason I have written, it is involved in oxidation, hence it is a reducing agent. Students, the species which is involved in oxidation called reducing agent, the species which is involved in reduction called oxidizing agent. We read in the first year. Yes, it is involved in oxidation called a strong reducing agent. It is involved in oxidation called strong reducing agent, lithium. So lithium, oxidation means losing electrons. SRP value is minus, lower value, that's why oxidation. But I wrote gaining electrons reduction. All I have written gaining in the series. I have written only 3 students. One is bottom one, middle one, and the top one. Observe the textbook. They gave a list totally. I didn't write all those. Okay, so in this list, these are all SRP values, standard reduction potential values. That's why only reduction I mentioned here. SRP value is negative, then it is involved in oxidation. But they shown reduction only, but practically they involved in oxidation based on the SRP value. It means reduction value less indicates oxidation. Getting? That's what. Yes. So Li configuration is 1s2, 2s1 students. It is 1s2. 1s2. It means one electron lost, then 1s2, 2s0. It becomes stable. It is stable. It is unstable. Right? Getting all of you? It is unstable becomes stable. It's trying to stable by losing electrons. Losing electron nothing but oxidation. Itself involved in oxidation called, it is oxidation. Okay, so itself involved in losing electrons nothing but oxidation, hence acting as lithium acts as strong reducing agent. Li plus 2 to Li, if you observe, stable to unstable is very difficult. Li plus gain one electron, Li plus gain one electron becomes Li, Li plus gain one electron becomes Li. So left to right to left, stable to unstable, very difficult. Every molecule is trying to become stable only but not unstable. That's why it will not come back weak. It means come back means gaining electron, Li plus gain one electron, then only becomes Li. Reduction, that is involved in reduction, means oxidizing agent. So unstable means weak oxidizing agent, right? Li plus is weak oxidizing agent. Very, very important these are, because Li plus is already stable. It will not gain electron. It will not involved in reduction. Not involved in reduction. Reduction means oxidizing agent. Not involved in reduction means weak oxidizing agent. Understood it is? Next, top one we will observe, students. Top one it is. The top one is, that is, fluorine gains 2 electron, then becomes F minus. The higher SRP value indicates reduction. So acting as oxidizing agents, right? Yeah. Fluorine configuration is, if you take 1 fluorine plus 1 electron, then becomes F minus. So fluorine is 1s2, 2s2, 2p5 it is. And it is one electron gained, 1s2, 2s2, 2p6 it is. Gained, p5 converted into p6. Then you just observe, it is unstable and it is stable, right? Unstable is trying to become more stable by gaining electron. It means reduction it is. Itself involved in reduction, then act as an oxidizing agent, right? Yes, I am writing here. For fluorine, the SRP value is very high. It indicates oxidation or reduction. High means SRP value high in the sense reduction takes place, itself involved in reduction, then F2 acts as strong oxidizing agent. The substance which is involved in reduction called oxidizing agent. Unstable to stable, that's why fluorine is which one, that is a strong oxidizing agent. Getting all of you? Next, F minus can lose one electron, becomes F. Can lose means oxidation. Itself involved in oxidation, that is a reducing agent. But already F minus is stable. It is very difficult to lose electron to become unstable. It means losing electron is difficult. It means oxidation is difficult. Oxidation difficult itself involved in oxidation is difficult means weak reducing agent. F minus is weak reducing agent. Reducing agent. Very simple students. You just observe clearly. Fluorine is a strong oxidizing agent. Opposite one is a opposite weak. Fluorine is strong oxidizing agent. F minus is weak reducing agent. Lithium is strong reducing agent. Li plus is weak oxidizing agent. Getting all of you? Very very important. So this these are important for your objective also. Next, few applications for which one, that is electrochemical series. What are the uses for electrochemical series? Now the first one is reactivity. Reactivity. Reactivity is directly proportional to oxidation. Oxidation means losing electrons, right? Directly proportional to oxidation. Oxidation taking place at anode. Oxidation means SRP value will be low. Low means top high, bottom low, right? It means top to bottom in that series. SRP value gradually decreases. Gradually decreases means lower value. SRP low means oxidation increases and reactivity also increases. Top to bottom in electrochemical series, SRP value will be low. That indicates oxidation favorable. Oxidation favorable. Oxidation increases, reactivity also increases. Reactivity also increases. That's why bottom lithium. Lithium is alkali metal. First year group elements are more reactive because of SRP values are low. Getting all of you? Yes. Next, stability point of view. Stability. So stability is inversely proportional to reactivity. Stability is inversely proportional to reactivity. So reactivity more for lithium, stability less for lithium. Reactivity less for fluorine when compared with others. So reactivity less for fluorine and stability more for fluorine. Inversely proportionality. Next, after that, displacement. Very very important is displacement. This is what important point, students. Displacement. It means in the displacement, the metal relatively with more positive value, more high positive SRP value or low negative SRP value. High positive indicates reduction taking place at always cathode, right? The metal relatively with more positive or less negative SRP value involved in more positive SRP means involved in reduction at cathode. Very very important. Cathode means right side, that is positive. Okay, RR CP given already. Reverse one, students. The metal with or metal ion relatively with more negative or less positive SRP value involved in involved in oxidation at anode left side, that is negative. It means lone students, simply taken as a lone, getting all of you. If you just put a box to this, it helps you a lot. Very, very important it is. Yes. High positive means reduction. Low positive means oxidation. High negative means oxidation. Low negative means, low negative is nothing but a positive value, reduction. Very, very important that is. Next. For example, lowest one is more reactive. Reactive. Reactive means oxidation. Oxidation means low SRP. Already given, no? Low SRP undergoes oxidation, reactive. That's why bottom one is more reactive. So that can displace the metal ion of the metal ion with high SRP, because lower one is more reactive, because lower SRP oxidation more reactive, right? Now the point is, the metal having lowest SRP, the metal having lowest SRP value, the metal having lowest SRP value will displace the metal from, will displace the displacement means, students, it is reduction. Very, very important. Displacement is also called a deposition. To displace the metal ion from its salt solution, displace metal ion from its salt solution. It means CuSO4 is there, that is a salt solution. Metal ion in CuSO4 is a Cu plus 2 salt solution, which has a higher SRP value, which has higher SRP value. Simply, that point is, low SRP metal can displace high SRP metal ion. Displace means reduction. Understood? So, low SRP can reduce the high SRP one. Very, very important. Displacement is reduction. Right? Dissolution means oxidation. Displacement meaning is reduction. It is nothing but deposition. Deposition. Metal ion converted into metal it is. Dissolution means dissolution. Dissolved. It is nothing but dissolved. Dissolving. It means what is that? Oxidation. Now, M converted into M plus electron. Deposition means smaller one becomes gradually larger. It is a deposition, students. Dissolution, during the dissolution, if any compound dissolved, the size will be decreased. Then the size in the beginning like this, afterwards in the beginning like this, afterwards size will be gradually, what happened here, size will be gradually decreased. Yes, dissolved gradually, that's what you need to remember. Simply one example I will give you. The example is, by taking this box we can explain the example, right? The example is, best example is zinc galvanic cell. Best example is galvanic cell. Net cell reaction of galvanic cell. Already given, students, zinc converted into Zn plus 2 and Cu plus 2 converted into Cu. right now. So zinc dissolved, that's why Zn plus 2, and Cu plus 2 reduced, that's why it is Cu. Yeah, for zinc SRP value is minus 0.76, for copper SRP value is plus 0.34. compare these two. So which is higher value? Relatively more positive value is copper. Copper is reduced, hence copper plus 2 reduced to copper by zinc. Understood? That reduction happened by zinc metal, and this value is low, hence zinc oxidized to Zn plus 2 by which one? That is copper, Cu plus 2, that is. So zinc is oxidized to Zn plus 2 by Cu plus 2. Getting all of you? So you just observe, lower one displaces. Displacement means reduction. The lower zinc SRP will be reduced as the Cu plus 2 to Cu. Understood? So zinc has low SRP, hence it displaces Cu plus 2. Displaces means reduced, reduction. Cu plus 2 to Cu, which has high SRP. Understood? Zinc, the low SRP zinc displaces high SRP copper plus 2 to copper. Very, very important it is. Right. Displacement, that is, students. Lower one can displace higher one. Very, very important. Now, another example. Displacement means reduction, remember. A has plus 0.50, B has plus 0.70 volts. Which undergoes oxidation, which undergoes reduction? That's what. Lower SRP of A has lower SRP, value 0.50, can displace means can reduce, it means reduction, nothing but can reduce B plus 2B, can reduce B simply, can reduce B, okay? It means B plus gain one electron, then gives rise to B, okay na? Because reduction, B should be reduced. So low SRP involved in oxidation, obviously. A lost one electron. Low SRP involved in oxidation, high SRP involved in reduction. Very, very important. Low SRP A can reduce high SRP B plus into B, metal ion into metal. That's what important, students. Okay. Next, after that, last point. So bottom, more reactive actually. It means oxidized. Oxidized means metal converted into metal ion by losing electron. Okay. So before hydrogen, the reduced form is unstable. Li plus is unstable. Sorry, Li is unstable. Already written, Li is unstable. It is Li is unstable. Where is that? Li is unstable. This is reduced form. It is reduced form. So before hydrogen, the reduced form of a metal will be unstable. Hydrogen is more stable. Okay. After hydrogen, yes, I'll write, if SRP of electrode is greater than 0, less than 0, the reduced form of metal is if SRP of metal is less than zero, the reduced form is less stable. Hydrogen is more stable. H2 gas is stable. Okay. Next, if SRP of metal is greater than zero, it means more than zero. More than zero means bottom reactivity more, top reactivity less. Already written, top reactivity less. Obviously, greater than zero, the reduced form is more stable than hydrogen. Reverse one, students. Getting all of you? I hope you understood. Follow this video perfectly and practice your notes which you wrote, and study sincerely, because a little tricky. If you have any doubts, post in our WhatsApp group.